Shabbat Shalom. One of the great arguments within the Torah is the machloket between Korach v'Anashav, Korach and his cohorts. In fact, the Mishnah in Avot, chapter 5, says that there are two types of controversies, of arguments, if you will. There are controversies which are considered l'shem shamayim, for the sake of heaven. Those are positive controversies, and the example is the controversies between Hillel and Shammai. And then there are the negative controversies. Those are the arguments between Korach and his cohorts. What is the difference between the two? What makes a controversy a bad controversy? What makes a controversy a good controversy that should last forever, according to the Mishnah? In order to explain, I want to explain the Hebrew word machloket, machloket, controversy. It can either be lachlok, to divide, or la'asot chiluk, to make a division. Now, la'asot chiluk is not so much to make a division as it is to make a distinction, to separate two things. Whereas machloket is to truly make a division, a divide, an impassable barrier between the two ways. Let me further explain. The Gemara in Eruvin says very clearly that the schools of Hillel and Shammai argued for 3 years. And finally a sound came down from heaven, bat kol, Elu ve'elu divrei Elokim chayim. Both views are the views that come from heaven. Both views have the divinity, God, in the views. That's a machloket between Hillel and Shammai. A legal issue. Is this permissible or not permissible? Can you do this thing or can you not do this thing? Halachically. What is the kind of machloket that lasts forever? You can never come to a conclusion about it. And it's negative. That's between Korach and his cohorts. Listen well to what the Mishnah says. Not between Korach and Moshe. Korach actually stood up against Moshe. It's not that kind of division. It's Korach and his cohorts. What's the point? When there are various opinions about a theological issue, about a political issue even, between two sides, each one has a position. And only when you understand both sides can you truly understand what the issue is supposed to do. When there is an argument between two sides, opposing sides, yes, but nevertheless intellectual, halachic, political. It is certainly possible to say, Eilu ve'eilu divrei Elokim chayim. They both have their correct issues. They both have a position that can be accepted, that makes sense, that is reasonable, provable. And therefore, the halacha says that kind of division, ideological division, that kind of difference can last forever, like Hillel versus Shammai. Ultimately, we have to give a psak halacha, right? And we give a psak halacha like Beit Hillel, because they were usually more easygoing, more reasonable, more lenient. And in general, halacha prefers that direction. But in some generations, we go like Shammai. There are certain times when you have to go like Hillel. And you can indeed say both help you to understand the truth, and neither side is absolutely true. And therefore, if you have a humane issue in front of you, and you need the easier, more lenient position, we always pass it that way. On the other hand, an argument between Korach and his cohorts was a personal argument. They didn't have two different ideological stands. Ideologically, both of them were against most of what Moshe said. They just had personal ad hominem argument. That doesn't go. That's not legitimate. And that's an argument that will never remain strong and positive. And therefore, Korach and his cohorts and their arguments are in the dustbin of history. Rav Kook, at the end of Ein Iyah, at the end of Masechet Brachot, has an amazing interpretation of this. He writes as follows: scholars increase peace in the world. Talmidei Chachamim marbim shalom ba'olam. A multiplicity of peace means that all sides and all views must be considered. Then it will be clarified how each one of them has its place, each one in accordance with its value, its place, its specific issue. And only through a collection of all sides and all details, all of those ideals which appear to be different, and all disparate professional opinions, only by means of this kind of argument, which tries to meet the truth for the particular decision to be made at hand. That kind of each position will help reveal the true wisdom of the Torah and the true love of God and the true light of eternal Torah. That's the argument of two sides. Each has part of the truth for the specific condition. When it's not hominem argument, it never makes sense, and it's never good, And it doesn't lead to peace, only to war. Shabbat Shalom.